Here we go with part one of season one, episode four. Not with A.A., B.B., or C.C. D.D. is my daughter, E.E.F.F. Effie? Nah, G.G. Let's go. And we are kind of live. So we're just sitting in the kitchen. Oh. Talking. Oh. No video. No video.
Hey, hello. How you doing?
It's
what day is it?
I don't know what day it is. It's Tuesday.
Tuesday the 26th.
The last Tuesday in the month of April.
Oh, it is, isn't it?
You know, shouldn't we? What did I say properly?
Yes, Miss Kumalo.
So usually we have had such spectacular times together that it brings out my inner French woman. Sometimes she comes in. Just now she was a little bit Creole. She's a little Haitian in there. Whatever. Ça va bien. I don't know why I'm saying give it to me.
But I know. I'm like, huh?
I know.
What?
But we were just admiring our conversation that we just laugh a lot. And I find it really helpful to me so that I'm not sad.
Me as well. Laughter is good for the soul.
It is.
And let me tell you, it sure is good for my soul because of what I've experienced through the weekend. Man.
You were glad the week started.
Thank you. I was
glad it was Monday.
Yes.
Dang.
And that's, you know, bad. And that's, and yeah, and that should not be. Especially when someone's saying that they care about you, you know, but their actions are showing something different. That's what makes it hard, but it's okay because it was not wasteful for me. It was elevation, you know, and I know how to proceed with certain individuals, okay? And it cracks me up. I'm going in. The individual says, well, I would hate to lose you. And I look like, I'm sure you will hate to lose me. But I'm up for fire. If you want to get rid of me. No, because that's how I feel. Because
really? Yeah.
This person brought up money.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. How she feels that I'm making the most money with her. And I'm like, this ain't about money, boo, because all money ain't good money.
Yeah.
Okay, you're not going to take my peace and my sanity away from me because it's a money.
And where do you get your money from?
Come on. Come on. That's what I was
do
like.
Do you make money?
No.
You know what I mean? She don't make money.
That's my point. And she ain't paying me. You know who paying me?
Right. There you
go. That's why I'm like looking at this person like, You kind of special, but I'm going to just lay you at the feet of Jesus right now. Okay? Just lay you there and leave you there.
Leave in the door of God.
And I'm going to walk the other way. And I'm not going to say too much to you because it's really going to be a waste of my good energy.
Hello.
So I just walk.
And walk on by.
Thank you.
So, bye,
and today
bye,
was
bye,
a different day.
Felicia. Walk on by.
Yeah.
Damn. But you know what? I hope that you don't ever have to feel this way again.
I'm not. You know what? Thank you. Thank you for the conversation because I did talk with you after that happened. And you was like, Gigi, you don't deserve that. And I was like, listening. She needs you more than you need her. You know what? I took that to heart. Because it opened up everything and made me see more of who Gigi is.
Yeah.
Okay? I'm a loving, giving person. I don't deserve to be treated like a doormat. I don't deserve to be micromanaged because I'm a caregiver. I'm going to give you the best that I can give you. I'm going to do the best that I could do for you. And if you can't understand that my car ain't working, you got the issue.
Yeah, and that's the thing. The people don't see that they have the issue. I find that people notice in other people issues that they want to point out to them because they're issues that they have themselves. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But instead of being able to say like, oh, you know, I know I'm jacked up and I'm messed up. I got this on my mind, that on my mind. I shouldn't mess with you. I'm going to stay over here by myself. Instead of saying that, mm-hmm. no, people will say like, I'll do that. Mm-hmm. Let me volunteer. Yeah. I'll get involved. Like, right. Don't volunteer for stuff. Don't participate in life so fully that you make yourself like somebody that people have to depend on. Because you're not together.
Right.
You're not together. You're a patient. You know, wallow in the realm of being a patient. Be happy.
Yes.
In your station.
Be understanding.
Be understanding. Be a patient. Be patient.
Yes.
If you're a patient, you must have patience.
You have to.
To put up with a lot of stuff, but... But, you know, it's an interesting personality to encounter in life.
Yeah.
And it makes you ask yourself a good question.
Yeah.
Or two or ten.
Right. It really does. Mm-hmm. And you know, I just pray on it. I just ask, how do I deal and how do I move in this situation? And I guess quiet. Get quiet and I listen and not quick to lash, because see, I've been quick to be like, what?
Let me tell you something.
Yeah, what you talking about? No, that ain't, I was quick, you know, because I felt attacked. Mm-hmm. But now it's kind of like, I'm sitting here like that.
Yeah.
Get it all lit. And then waited 5 minutes after it was silent. Can I talk to you? Mm-hmm. Yeah. And it's like, I laid every little thing she's talked about, that person, I made a comment on that. And it was positive comments. This. Look at yourself. This person had just came out the store, and a man in the store called her a jerk. You're a jerk. So that she was going on that day.
Wow.
Called her just with how she was acting.
Wow.
And she was.
A jerk.
So, it is what it is. You know, when I went to work today, I was happy because I had peace within myself. That GiGi, you did the best, you are doing the best you can for this person.
And that's all that you can do every day, right?
Yeah.
It's just your personal best in your job, in yourself.
There you go.
In your life, yeah. In your relationship with Creator.
That's all I can do.
Because that's the only one that's watching you.
Come on. Yeah.
To say, I love you.
Yeah.
I see you.
That's
beautiful.
You know
I love
what?
You.
Yes.
Okay, you can do that now. Okay, let's go. I'm with you. Let's go.
Exactly. And that's where I'm beginning to be. Because I wasn't there before. So, last week and this weekend, I have learned a whole lot. And I'm so grateful. So grateful for it.
I have to applaud you.
I don't know about that. Let me give you one too, right?
Yes, why not? You know, because we need that. You know, like you need somebody to cheer for you. Mm-hmm. And to actually witness. You know, I'm bearing witness of what you just said. You understand that, right? So it's my honor to see you. And to know you another week. We've gotten to know each other a little bit longer.
Yes.
A little bit longer.
Yeah.
A little bit longer.
That's too... I keep smelling that beautiful scent and it's like... I want to put it on my body, but...
Well, they're all behind you. All the essential oils are right there. You're more than welcome.
I think it's you. I think that scent is coming from you. I don't know what you put in your water or what you did or mixed the two or what. Because it keeps like...
Oh, wow. Because I wore this shirt already.
So I put it on.
I think it's what you put. I think it's whatever. I don't know.
Well, I do find that life is better with essential oils. You know, just to have it in the air can just help to set the tone. You know, if you have the TV on, or you have the radio on, or the windows are open, like I'm on the ground floor, so when the summer comes, it'll be really noisy there. And it'll be happy noise, kids playing and stuff like that. But it's not quiet. It's never, ever quiet. So I do miss that kind of thing. So I do use a lot of essential oils and things to just kind of give my environment a helping hand.
That's really good.
Well, I'm glad that I smell good. I'm glad that I smell good, and I'm glad that I'm having a really good day, and I'm glad that it's Tuesday.
Because
I love seeing you on Tuesday. I look forward to like this day out of all the days in the week.
Really?
Yeah. That's why, if you know, people want to act like knuckleheads, and you know, you need to tell them to step to the curb. You always have some hours with me.
This is what I was thinking when she was talking. I was like, do you not know I can be like, bye-bye? I can see you 2 weeks out of a month and take on some other stuff. Did you not? So I was like, okay. But, you know, a lot of times, you know, when people treat me bad, or I don't really have to say too much, because God, he takes over and he convicts them. I don't even have to say anything, but I need to stay consistent with who I am.
That's
in
right.
order for him to put into action what he needs
yeah
to
because
do.
The blessings that are coming in front of you that you need to have, because they're for you, mm-hmm. you might miss,
right?
And you don't want to miss them.
No, I sure don't.
You don't want to miss them. So just, you know, keep your eye on the prize of you,
yeah,
and going in the directions, the way that you go, the choices that you make makes you a wonderful person. So don't change that.
Mm-mm.
But I do like when you say, like, well, you know, like, I trust God and God is guiding my steps. Mm-hmm. So it seems like I'm turning in this direction. I'm going over here.
Right.
Okay, maybe I'm not. I'm going to go over here, you
right.
know, but
right.
I'm not alone. God is with me.
Right. Every step.
Every step. So I'm not making a bad decision. Mm-hmm. And when we make a bad decision, we feel it. Something about it that's just
we
like
do mm. yeah right
you know there's a face with it
yeah it's like that wasn't yeah mm.
right
mm-hmm. yeah definitely
that's why I like being black
yeah
because we have all sorts of expressions of our blackness mm-hmm. sounds of blackness was no joke. To remember, that should be our mantra that we sing every day. Keep your head to the
keep
sky.
Right.
Be all you can be.
Right.
Be positive.
Yeah.
So that's what you're doing. And that's why I applaud you. Because you're doing
it. I'm trying.
You aren't trying. You're doing it.
Well,
you do it.
Probably because I had a talking to my son when I was driving him home yesterday, and I was like, you know what? I was like, God always tells me, I got you. Stop worrying. And yet, I worry about certain things, and the things that I worry about, he comes through, and it's like, what you was doing on that for? What?
You could have used your time to do something else.
Thank you. So it's kind of like
you chose to do this.
Yeah.
Even though I gave you roses and daffodils and everything.
Come on.
You went and picked a dark, dark corner where nothing's growing.
Yeah. What do you do that for? That's what you be saying. What you do?
Come on over here. Come to the light.
Yeah.
Come to the light.
So I'm working on trying to stay in a good place and knowing that I'm provided for, I'm protected, and I'm loved.
Highly favored.
And highly favored. And sometimes it's hard to hold on, but I'm working on it.
And then you're surrounded by other like-minded spirits like yourself. So you're not alone.
Right.
You got somebody else that's here saying, like, I get you.
Yes.
And you're right. I know how you feel.
Right.
Literally.
And then you get... and you get Satan. He was like,
Ooh.
No, you buy. I'm running the other way. But I get just what you're saying, mm-hmm. you know, and this is where shedding people, getting rid of people that mean no good. So I just been praying.
That's why it was like weird with Santa Claus, because it was like, I'm trying to be nice to say goodbye.
Yeah.
Don't make me call you Felicia, because you might not even get that joke.
Right.
And that's my point.
Right.
But I couldn't even do that because it was almost like, I guess the word vampire comes to mind, because there are people that behave that way, that they realize that whatever it is that you have, I just want to...
Ooh, yeah.
I yeah. love you. No, you don't.
No, you don't.
Vampire?
Yeah.
Get on back.
Right.
Get on back. And that's...
I can relate to that.
This is the trickiness of Lucifer.
Girl, and I was tricked. That's why I can sit up here. I was tricked with Preacher Man.
Yeah, I know.
And look, I had never experienced nothing like... I'm 58. And did not see it coming. But what's more important is I woke up.
Changing who you are, because you're a beautiful person and you should love on people the way that you do.
Yeah.
It was just the wrong person. So now that you know.
You know what I struggled with?
What?
Talking about that. Because I am that loving person. I struggled with the fact, do I continue to allow this person to text me? Do I allow this person to call me when this person get a whim or whatever? Do I allow that? And I struggle with it. It's like, because the nice part of me is like, you can be nice, but keep your distance.
Mm.
So I was like, okay. Being nice. When you see this person's name pop up on your phone, how do it make you feel?
Mm.
And I had to ask myself that. Like, it makes me feel hurt. But yet, I'm trying to keep that open.
I'm being the bigger person.
Yeah.
Even though I don't... I'm still going to be... I'll just... One more time.
Those are the exact... That's right on the head. Okay. Then I started blessing God. I was like, Lord, what do I do with this situation? Okay, what do I do? And I don't know if he sent somebody to say this to me, or I kept hearing block. Just block. Block. Don't stop. Stop receiving messages.
Right. Right.
In the first week I did it, I would have wanted to unblock it to see if this
did
person...
Did he call?
Yeah.
Did he try?
Yeah. And I didn't. And I was like...
You got to observe yourself.
Mm-hmm.
You got to observe yourself in a way that you don't even like to see yourself.
Girl.
Like checking to see your phone, like...
I know. Because I would do that.
I did that too with my husband as we were getting divorced. I kept looking. Maybe he's trying to call me. Maybe he's trying to... That went on for like almost a year. And then I realized that it had become a habit. That I just, that was part of what I do. Like, I can get a glass of water. I can get a spoon for my tea. I can go check my messages to see if he called.
Yeah. I did. Yep.
What is that? Where did I go?
Yeah, right.
Where did we go in the story that we are the lead of? How can we be the lead in our own story and then we're not in our story? And we write the script. Wow. Listen, we got to keep our collaboration going. Because somehow through prayer and meditation, that's the collaboration. That's the collaboration. Because otherwise we have to depend on other people. And other people got their own shit they're going through. But you can count on you.
Right.
You can officially, like you said, I'm 58. You know, like, 58. You can count on you.
Yeah.
Now is the time to just
happy.
Count on you.
GiGi, focus on you. Mm-hmm. And the people who do care about you and love you.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Not somebody's trying to suck, take from you. And it's not physical stuff that he's taking, but spiritually he's draining me.
Energy. Energy. That's what vampires suck. Mm-hmm. Energy. So how can you notice that you're missing energy until you realize that you're drained?
Thank you.
And then you think about what's been draining you.
Right.
And it's like, oh, every time I think about, I gotta stop doing that. Let me check my phone first.
Yeah, right? Yeah. No, it's the truth, too.
Oh, my goodness. We have been talking for 22 minutes so far and not really telling everybody what they're listening to and who we are. I'm Wobbi Kamala. This is my podcast, Ability Over Disability, where I talk about all the things that I like to talk about because I am curing multiple sclerosis one step at a time. And I'm talking to my favorite person to see on Tuesdays. Because she only comes to see me on Tuesday. She don't love me on Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, but Tuesday.
Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday,
Thursday,
Thursday, Friday, Saturday.
Oh,
hey.
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 I'm here talking with my friend,
GiGi.
Williams. And she is my home care provider and kind of like my sister friend, cousin. We just like from the day we met. We were kind of put together by my social worker that said, you need to meet you.
Divinely.
Here we are. And we were just wanting to record and share our joyful, funny conversations with everybody.
Oh, crazy days.
Yeah. And you know, women, it's not easy for women.
No.
It's not easy for a black woman.
No.
In particular.
No.
Because we happen to be.
Yes. But we are.
Yes, we is.
What's that song? Eye of the Tiger.
Woo! It's just the eye of the tiger. That one?
You don't know. It's like the eye of the tiger. It's the thrill of the night. Da, 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 da.
Joy of our rivals and the last known survivor and the king of the pack. And so on it goes on, it goes on. I'm the tiger.
Yeah.
Yeah, I thought you were talking about that new song.
Here's a new one? No, you know what was a new song? Let me stop. I love that song, but.
Which one?
It's called Woman.
Uh-oh, I don't know that.
By Doja Cat.
Oh, I love Doja Cat.
Woman, let me be a woman. It's about a dude. The video, this dude is trying
Doja
to take
Cat.
Over her.
Boy, oh, boy.
She is, and she been getting backlash. But she needs to know, Doja, if you ever get to listen to this podcast, the reason you getting backlash because you are somebody, girl. Someone told me if you ain't talked about, you're nobody. But if you talked about, you're somebody. Trust that.
Yeah, and I'm gonna quote Sweet Honey in the Rock. Not that they're my personal friends,
Babe.
But I just have to quote their beautiful writing. I don't know who wrote it in the group, but you are young. You are positive. You are the future. You gotta tell it like it is. You won't let anyone stand in your way. Your eye is on the prize. You gotta stay that way. Hey. Doja Cat.
Yeah.
Hashtag.
Yep.
Eye on the prize.
Yep.
And just your name is so beautiful.
Yes.
To pick that name. Yes. Doja Cat.
Doja Cat. Get it, girl.
Get it. Mm. Hey. And if you ever need some background singers,
we here.
Well, hello.
Yes, right. We can do it.
We can do it for you. That's especially right. If you need a little retro in your thing. Come you on. Know, like we can bring in some retro.
Yeah. Man.
Kind of like an East Coast, West Coast kind of USA international zonage.
Yes.
Ish. Yes. Like. But seriously. Yeah, Doja Cat. I mean, there's some great artists. That is a great song that she has. And just, like, they're, like, so spot on for, like, social justice. Mm-hmm. And that's what I like seeing again. That there's artists actually writing again words that are like, this is what's happening now. This has happened to me. This isn't right. This is how I made it right. This is what I'm going to do moving forward. What's that song Woman about?
This king trying to take over her territory. Okay, so she's got her own kingdom and he's got his kingdom, and she's trying to tell this dude, instead of trying to take over me, let me help you and join you and build. Let's build together.
Do you know that most of the pharaohs in Egypt and on the African continent were women? And I believe that Doja Cat is one of the artists that is prompting DC and some of these other Marvel companies to create more black heroes and rulers and characters. Not just villain characters, but strong women characters. And I think that she's like going to be one of those characters. I think that's one of her deals that she has.
That would be perfect because she's very talented, and all her videos are just spot on.
I'm just amazed at like what the young people are doing now, like these new artists that are on the scene. Mm-hmm. I just feel so blown away by them. Because as I'm trying to do my little thing, you know, I realize like I am just of a different generation.
Yeah,
you know, and this is a beautiful generation that I still represent. Mm-hmm. But this new generation? Yeah. These are my children's age?
Yes. Yeah.
This is our future.
Yeah.
So we're either going to be fine when we're 99, or we're going to be in somebody's Soylent Green. You remember that movie?
Yeah, well, however, it'll be all right.
Somebody will be eating us like, this is really tasty. What did you make tonight? My mother-in-law.
Yeah.
Do you remember that movie from the 70s?
No. They ate somebody.
Yeah.
Picked them up, chopped them up.
Yeah, they, like, when people would die.
I think I've seen it.
They
movie.
Would create a food source to feed people because there were so many people in the world.
Okay.
The world was overcrowded. So as people were dying... And I think part of it was like, let's kill people so we can make more food.
I think I've seen that. Because they had some of them in the backyard or something. And they wasn't fully dead, but they was in the plants or something. I think
weird.
That's this movie. I remember seeing it.
It was weird.
It was a weird movie.
It was a weird
was
movie.
Good.
And I think that they wound up with a factory. They wound up with a factory where it was almost like the Holocaust. Like you walked in the front door and you came out a biscuit.
That's right. Man, you never know what they're doing.
You never know. And that's why, you know, when we go to these supermarkets, we're always on autopilot. But we gotta be careful. We really should just be mindful. Even though it's a safe place. I mean, you figure Whole Foods. Whole Foods. It's Whole Foods. You see the prices they charge? It's organic. We don't know.
Organic,
we're not the,
what? What's, what you put out there to be grown organic?
Like, I want to grow food. Like, I want to try to, like, help farming in some way.
Yeah. If we had some land, we could do it.
We should do it. We should get some land.
I've been praying. If God blesses me, yeah.
Well, let's form a cooperative.
What's that?
Like my family, which is me, mm-hmm. and your family, mm-hmm. and if another family mm-hmm. wanted to, we could buy a piece of property mm-hmm. and have a building on it that we could live. And maybe if it was big enough, like an apartment building, we could rent it out. Mm-hmm. Say it was an old apartment building that mm-hmm. needed fixing up. Mm-hmm. We all can help to fix it up. And then we can live there. Right. And then if we fix one apartment, we could rent that one apartment.
Right.
So we could have like a business plan. Because who knows what the future holds, except we're going to get older.
Yes.
We'll still be black. And we don't want to be a biscuit. We don't want to be a biscuit. We want to, you know, we want to just have the best life we can make for ourselves. And we have a lot of wonderful assistance from our government. You know,
half of the stuff they ain't telling us about.
Yeah, but the stuff that they do tell us about that we don't know is to our advantage. And I think that that's what Dred Scott was about. You know, Dred Scott.
I don't know who Dred Scott is.
Dred Scott was a freed slave who became like a politician once he was no longer acting like he was enslaved. Saying it's about time the rest of y'all woke up. Now let's talk about these laws that y'all are writing. They're not fair. I think that they should be like this and that. And they were like, oh, really? And the black people were like,
shh, what did
you
say?
What did you do? And he's like, we shouldn't whisper. That's my phone. We shouldn't whisper and we should... Conversation.
I dropped my call.
You dropped yours?
Yeah.
Oh no.
I'm waiting for a new one.
Oh no.
Yep, that's a new phone too.
That's an iPhone?
No.
That's a Galaxy.
It's a Galaxy. It's a Google.
It's a Google. It's a beautiful phone.
Well, I dropped.
Beautiful glass.
Yeah. I need to get a cover. That's what I get for procrastinating, but I don't mean to get you off of that thought.
Yeah.
It just remind me because you got a nice case on that.
Otterbox.
I need an Otterbox.
Yeah, Otter.
Otterbox.
Otterbox.
Okay.
Great company. Mm-hmm. And check their sales because they might have like a new edition of something, so their older one is on sale now, and that could be a phone that fits that older one. You don't need the newer one.
Right.
And you can get all sorts of bargains on their website.
We'll do that.
And they're great. I've used them for years. I've been using them for my iPhones for years. 10 years or more. Probably 20. Closer to 20 years. And they're flexible. Their cases are fairly flexible, too. So not only is it protective, but it's flexible.
Right.
So it has a certain amount of, you know... And so they make the phone for your model, you know, that you're buying.
Glass too. Mm-hmm. That's pretty blue.
Isn't it pretty? Mm-hmm. But you know what? I never see the blue because I keep it in a case.
Right.
But I forget that I bought, because everybody's like, oh, you're going to get the new blue one. And I was like, I don't give a shit.
Yeah, right.
I just need a phone.
Thank you.
And I was desperate. That's why I got this small size, 64.
Because that's just really too long for me, but that's what I had to go to.
Well, maybe you can get a different phone. even though, you know, like, you can replace it with something different that's smaller. Oh, you ordered the same one? Did you order the case? No, you're going to order the OtterBox case later today. Yeah. Hey, Siri. Send Jeanie a text message.
Which one? Jane or Jeanie Wiggins? Which of these should I use for Jeanie Wiggins? Which of these should I use for Jeanie Wiggins? What do you want to say to the group?
Hey, Jeanie, don't forget to order an OtterBox case for
you. Ready to send it?
Yeah, send it.
Okay, it's sent.
That's funny. We're like...
There you go.
Okay, so we're like, what, 2 feet from each other?
Isn't that something?
Yeah. It's amazing. But there was something I was trying to say. I can't remember.
See,
can't remember the story.
Talking about the black
Dred Scott. Yeah. Hey Siri, who was Dred Scott? Oh, your battery is low. Hey Siri, who was Dred Scott?
Dred Scott was an enslaved African-American man who, along with his wife, Harriet, unsuccessfully sued for freedom for themselves and their two daughters in the Dred Scott v. Sanford case of 1857, popularly known as the Dred Scott decision. Should I keep going?
Yeah, keep going.
The case centered on Dred and Harriet Scott and their children, Eliza and Lizzie.
Yeah, so, like, he, like, went through the court system, you know, and everything they were saying, like, well, you can't say that. You can't do that. He'd say, why not? And they'd say, well, you don't have a this or a that. He'd go get the this or that, like, in an instant. And white people just didn't like to see such an independent, freed man. They were like, This isn't gonna be. And he says, it's the Constitution. Why not? Just because y'all wrote this in here, you just added this. And they were adding stuff during the Civil War to the Constitution. So this country has had a lot of lies and secrets that it's been keeping. And when you're smart enough to figure it out and you speak up, you wind up being somebody that can be Googled. But we need to keep teaching and speaking about Dred Scott, because he did that for his family. And his wife, who happened to be named Harriet, as in Harriet Tubman, but not that Harriet, but still, that was a name given to women that were pretty strong. You know, like Phyllis, Harriet, those were like strong black women. Wow, imagine Phyllis. Anyway, there's so many amazing things about American history that we've never really been taught the truth, but the truth is there, and you can see it. And the way that things have been noted at the time that they were happening, you know, almost the way that they drew pictures, they were telling the truth. Like this one school in my school district where I was raising my kids had a mural on the wall of their auditorium. They have it on both walls. I just remember the one wall. But they had a mural of the guy who the school was named after, William S. Mount. And the school was Mount Elementary School. So I'm in the theater to do my little show, and I'm looking at the wall in the auditorium, which probably had a seating for almost 1,000 students. So it wasn't a small school, you know, it was a nice little lily white school district. Nice little... And now on that wall is the story of William S. Mount. And there was more black people in that drawing and that painting than white. I was like, there were Native Americans in that painting. I was like, how can I be in a lily white neighborhood and they have an elementary school that has this painted on the wall? So wait, back in the, what was it, the 30s and the 40s? The 30s? The government did like a working program for people. So they created jobs so that people could have a job. And one of the things that people could do was paint murals and build buildings. It was something, it was like Eisenhower, or no, before Eisenhower. Coolidge, or after Coolidge. One of those presidents in there, after the Civil War, came up with like all sorts of things. You know, like, first of all, the world created a war. We didn't need to go to war. Europe didn't need to go to war. World War I did not need to happen. But people needed a war. People needed a disease. People needed, like, problems. The people that need those kind of things to feed their energy, because they're vampires. And they get together in groups called fraternities or sororities. I mean, lawyers, doctors, senators, and congressmen. So they all get together and form these little cliques and sororities, fraternities, and then they make rules for each other. Mm-hmm. And say, okay, let's not let anybody else in our group. And you have to wear blue. If you're going to be in our group, you're going to wear blue. Because those guys over there, they wear red. And we don't want to wear red. We're going to wear blue. And then we'll know that this is our group. Mm-hmm. But they don't tell anybody. Mm. And this is how society forms itself, you know? Mm-hmm. And it's just travel through time. God's timeline of people, of things that exist. We have no idea what the truth really is. We have no idea what the truth really is. We have no idea. Everything we've been told by somebody else. Right? Most things in our life, somebody told them to us. It wasn't something that we discovered. This relationship, this energetic spiritual relationship that's unexplainable. There's no words for it. But then the fact that you just giggled, you know exactly what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
And that's the amazing thing. That is really where it's at.
Because there's no words for it.
There's no words for it. And it suffices over everything. Mm-hmm. Which means that nothing matters. Nothing matters. Mm. Then we come back into the reality, which is like, oh no, it does matter, because I gotta look at my watch and I gotta know my this and I gotta know my that and da da da. And off we go. But this moment that we pause on Tuesdays is always special. It's always special because I know that I can have some like deep conversations with you about everything.
Everything.
Anything.
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 And we have such a good time talking. Yeah. Every time.
Be for real.
Yeah.
I'm gonna be straight up.
And it's such a blessing to have somebody in your life that you can feel this way about. Because mm-hmm. It's not guaranteed. It's not a promise. It's not.
And some people you can't tell everything. And some people you can't tell everything. It's like, this is who I am.
Yeah. So I'm glad that your car is working again.
Yes. Flat, all the screws out, and then the nail in the tire, and I was like, how was this happening all this week? I was like, oh, you're being attacked. Okay. they really didn't feed me anything Sunday. I almost got up and walked out. Because sometimes you know what you know. Okay? So I was like, but I said, I'm going to stay. And I stayed. And then after that, I had my Mediterranean dinner down the block. And I invited that guy. It's all good. But then Monday come. Monday is good. Okay, easy. Cleaning up my apartment, throwing out stuff. Man, I threw out some stuff. I need it. Stuff up in my cabinets.
Wow.
Yeah. Clothes. I got a couple. Matter of fact, I gotta take some stuff to the goodwill.
That's like a good spring cleaning.
I'm done. You see my apartment. There's stuff still laying around, but I filed my papers away, ripped up papers, and you know, and it's a process. And I still got more to do. You yawning too? I just see.
I yawned before you,
but you didn't see it. I kept it.
Yeah, you didn't see it. But that means that we just need oxygen.
Yes,
take some
exactly.
good breaths.
That's what that is. Because I was wondering, because when I be singing sometimes, and I was like, I would yawn. It was like, I'm not sleepy, y'all. It was like, GiGi, you're not taking enough oxygen and you're singing.
And singers take nice and deep breaths, you know, so we fill up like our lungs fully down here.
Yeah.
You know, and we just like all the way. Yeah. And we just fill up with air. And then we've got space.
Because our talking is the.
Yep. And then it's leaving.
So it takes more.
Leaving, leaving, and then we don't even breathe. We just take a gasp, little gasp, and then we just keep talking and talking, and then we're laughing. And then. Steeping all this time, and I thought, like, yeah, I never use this little thing.
Why is it still in the box?
And I wanted to like have that so that I could have
it
tea.
It was so cute, you know? Yeah, it was so pretty. I seen it in. I got mine from Winco.
Okay.
They had them on sale, and I seen it, and I was like, and I had to get it, and it's still sitting in the box. And I said, I'll get it out every day. I got new. My house is coming. And then it's gonna be like, I'm gonna have my tea and my stuff. And wood floors, and jacuzzi on the back. All around. Just gonna lay back and sit on my couch and be like, thank you. I arrived. This is what I was waiting for. What's next?
Or as I like to think, now I'm ready to die. Because I got everything I wanted. I'm good to go. All I have to do is just wake up.
I might get my house. I'd be like, okay, next, where my husband? Or I might get the house and the husband
you might.
Together.
If you manifest them both at the same time.
Ooh, I've been praying. I was like, Lord, just send me the right. I've been writing down what I want.
Yeah, ask specifically.
In him.
I'm going to write, no more Santa Claus.
Please. No more Santa Claus. No.
No more Santa Claus. But thank you for giving me a chance to reflect on it.
Yeah, you need it. That was put there just to
remind myself.
That's the word, remind.
And that's why you notice that I'm looking better, because I've been taking better care of myself. You know, yes. Like, I'm really, like, you know, making sure I'm dressed today.
Yes, you're good.
You know, and I'm just doing that every day. Like, yes. I wake up, I check to see what time I'm waking up, and it's usually in between, like, 6 and 7:30.
You're feeling better.
Feeling better. Which means if I'm waking up like that on my own, I had a good night's sleep.
Right.
And then I'm like, what do I do today? And it's like, say, thank you, God.
Yes.
I was like, oh, I should say prayer. I was like, why don't you just do it? And I'm still in the bed like, yeah. And then I say my little prayers. And I'm like, oh, I gotta pee. And then I slowly get up. Because I remember my physical therapist said, keep something nearby that you can grab onto when you're getting out of bed. Because if you're going to try to stand up on your own, you might fall.
Right.
So make sure there's something you can grab onto. And I don't think there is anything that I can grab onto, because my bed's on the floor. So I just kind of like do my little yoga thing until I'm able to brace myself to stand up. And by then I'm peeing on myself.
Oh. Well, you know what? You're not alone. Because I literally be, I'm going like, I be getting up out of my bed and I go like this. And I walk a couple of feet and I go,
right?
And I'm like, what the heck is going on? And then it comes out before I get sits on the toilet. So yep. My panties,
everything.
I don't sleep in panties, but during the day, if I do that, I got an extra pair of clothes in the car because I wet myself.
Well, what's this up? Is why people that are fashionable as you.
Wear the tins in there?
Well, yes, but they make them so nice that they're called silhouette.
Whoa.
And they look like really nice panties.
Maybe I should get some silhouettes.
I think you should, because they will look like your panties. In your mind, you'll be thinking, I'm wearing panties. But when that happens, you'll say, I'm wearing panties.
Yeah, because I'll be working sometimes and don't get to the bathroom.
Mm-hmm. So the other thing...
Don't let me be drinking.
Mm-hmm.
It's all over.
Hey. You'll be dancing to the bathroom and be like, hey, hey.
My cousin, we were downtown and we literally had to... She squatted. Like New York style, mm-hmm. in the corner.
But she was so
drunk. I'm like, why you drink like that? And I'm asking her that, why you do that? And I know I had my day.
You're like, let me know when you finish with the corner.
And then she called the Uber to take her home, cause she, you know, Uber, cause she knew she was gonna be drinking.
Mm-hmm.
Why she pee in the Uber in the people's seat? I told her.
She peed in the seat.
Yes, I said, was it a lot? She says, no, it was just a little tinkle. I said, well, maybe it didn't go through to the seat. It just went on your clothes. So I was like.
So after she peed in the corner of the street, she gets in an Uber and pees in the
again.
Uber. She needs some silhouette.
You know what? Matter of fact, I think I'll bring that to her attention now.
I was
like, when you come out, we out partying, get your silhouette, babe.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You know, and this way you can have a good old time.
I used to be in the choir in Sunday morning, and I would sing, and I would be singing so hard and cold and supporting, because the songs were difficult. I would tinkle. And I would think to myself, I hope I didn't pee a stream and the whole congregation saw that. Oof. I would have a long skirt on, but it's like...
Still.
Silhouettes.
Yep.
I started... One time I wore Depends to singing. I remember that day because I was having troubles. And, I would be singing.
A huge difference. I mean, it really makes a huge difference. You know, because I realize, like, I'm not wearing them when I go to sleep. And then I'm struggling in the morning. And then I was just like, as soon as I would even hit that, like, white thing there, I'm already peeing. So I'm like, I don't want to pee on the rug.
Yeah, right.
You know, it's like, how do I step over? And it's like, don't lose your balance.
Yeah.
Like, what are you going to do to walk quickly? because, man. And I would just pee all the way. Get right to the toilet. Sit down.
Clean it up. Man, that's hard. That's hard.
Yeah, it was ugly. It was ugly. Yeah. And then it got to the point where I just did it so often that one day I realized that I would just, like, take off my shirt and then wipe it all up on the way back to bed.
Yeah, right? That's funny.
And I think when I got to there, I was like, damn, that was a lot of... That's like my morning pee.
Yeah, that's a lot.
Damn! So now I gotta do my floors. I can't have pee pee on my floors and know that, like, how many days have I been pissing on my floor? So sometimes I get in the bathroom and I'm like,
do you smell like pee? You asked me something one day, do it smell like what? I was like, what? No.
Yeah, because sometimes I'm telling you, I'm like peeing on the way there, so I'm like peeing as I sit down. So it's just like,
yeah, I'm everywhere. Man.
So I was like, okay. You got this. Keep it organized. You got these extra bottles of water because you don't have your tower garden anymore, but you got all this water ordered. You can't give it back. And then again, you didn't ask. Yeah, I guess. I don't know. It's not the water that I drink. It's not the water for that water cooler.
Oh, okay.
That was the water to grow my plants in.
Oh.
This is more like spring water in a glass bottle, not a plastic bottle. So it's like, oh. And then I think, boy, I'm stupid. I'm a real stupid consumer that I think, like, this is the best water in this clear bottle. I can tell it's better than everybody else. I had the best water. I paid $40 for the bottle. It's because it's the best. They have to ship it here.
Yeah, right.
Because the water's better over there than right here. I live in Oregon. Oh, the water here is terrible. I don't know what the water here is. And somebody told me, for $40, the water is good here. The water is just fine. You know, like, I don't know what you're, like, preventing. And I was like, I don't know either, but I do want spring water. And then I'm like, you're such a bougie. Bougie coon. A little bit of an accent. Bougie coon. Me? I am not a bougie coon. Je ne sais quoi. Peut-être.
Yeah.
Yeah, maybe. But yeah, I like over water. You know, like. And I'm coming to terms with, I need to be mindful that I don't have a lot of money. I'm on a fixed monthly income. I don't need to buy $30 bottles of water and pay for a water cooler to keep it hot. So on the rare occasion that I want to have tea,
just pour the hot water in there and it'd be ready.
Which I did, but I didn't sit down to drink the tea when it was hot and ready.
Yeah, it's so
good. Yeah, but I, like, defeated my own purpose of, I could have just gone to the thing with the tea bag and a mug.
You boiled it?
I boil it with the hot water.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that way. So I'm like, you want tea? So every time Elizabeth was coming, I was saying, would you like some tea? She was like, no. I got my water cooler. I'm good.
Yeah.
So you don't want any tea?
She's nice.
She is nice. She is nice. And the other day, I actually kind of missed my other guy. The other therapist I was seeing. Because we spent just about a year together. That was a long time to spend with the therapist, like, sharing all your things. And then I realized, like, I've got a lot of things, you know, like, my things are actually... Thanks for listening. Stay tuned for part 2.